morning, or well, afternoon, evening, whatever it is for you guys. Here's the moment we've all been waiting for. The full cycle wash with my work pants of the 65 Lady Kenmore. Last of my aerial detergent, just the phosphated stuff, the good stuff. I gotta go back and get some more. That is the last of it. Not even about 3/4 of a cup. So I'm just gonna wash the work pants. Work shirts. I have a lot of work shirts that need to be done, but not concerned about them right now. I think this will be one of the first videos of its kind on YouTube, full cycle of the belt drive. Like this one, this particular model, I think Paul Shacks up in Canada has a machine just like this one, except it's turquoise, and not sure about any others. They actually do pop up from time to time. I'm a pretty big fan of the shade of copper tone, so I'm not complaining at all. So this is the first wash load that it's done with actual clothes, probably 10 years or so. Watch the other video, you know, a little bit of the background, but I got it from Gordon in Charlotte. He was kind enough to sell me the set, and Paul's machines were the inspiration for me getting this one. I fell in love with these machines. And now owning one and having one, yes. And this agitator seems to do a great job, but we'll see how she does. This thing might suds up, suds lock, I'm not sure. It'll be interesting to see what it does. But of course, hot wash. Absolute hottest. Yep, that's hot. Nice and hot. And they definitely fell about the same way as Frigidaire. We're about 4 minutes in now. It'll be in and out of the room periodically. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video. Start in second. I've got an infinite water level on here, but I'm setting it to the lowest position. It stops up pretty high. Probably have to adjust that. Probably get away with adjusting that. It should start in second here now. There goes. pretty dirty shit. See how it does with this. This thing's full of grease and dirt. Perfectly level. Scummy load at the end of the wash. I predict that's going to be pretty nasty. Little malfunction, darn camera fell. Kind of like everything else, I have to have it somewhat rigged in order to get you guys able to see any sort of machines. I need to get a tripod. The camera works fine, it's just needing a tripod. suds like Frigidaires or Calvinators or even the even some of the other brands that generate suds like those do. Whirlpool with a circulator. The only thing it's missing is a tub light. I think tub lights were a thing we're just about done with by the time this machine was built. You know, the 50s Kenmores, especially the top line ones, Lady Kenmores, the 80s and the 800s, 900s, whatever. They all, a lot of them had tub lights, some of them had a hose on them, like right here, and then they had to have the tub light right here at the front. My 58 Imperial Timeline has a tub light and a hose on. They work intermittently. Thank you. camera fell again. I'm just gonna hold it the rest of the wash. Put this Frigidaire back. See how it does the spin. Oh man, look at that. Good old 500 RPM spin. 525. Let's kill. I've seen yet is a 1-18. Maytag's decent too. Second year for a 3-speed Kenmore. 64 is the first year of 3-speed.
fabric conditioner and your bleach. I'm gonna take this out and clean it properly. And all it is, I think it's just a little trip sensor. You just push it over. Could be wrong though. Normally the lids, I think, are supposed to open about 90 degrees. And you see there's some dirt in there, and I'm going to clean that. Most of it had quite a bit of dust on it before I bought it. I set it down while it's filling. Take the lid out. Take the lid out and just get it pretty clean. They take their time, I see. This looks like it's gonna crack in here. I think that's gonna manufacture it. That's what that looks like. Got the old school K in the middle. It's like a scrubber cap. I think that's what its intentions were. It's like an original K on there. These agitators, I think this is the first year of them, and I think they're made 65 or 68. You can see her little towel in there. I think it's buried in the back, maybe. Probably buried in the back. I wish they didn't have this D shaped inlet hole for the clothes in. I really like, I'm so used to the Frigidaires now, I'm used to just having the full tub visible. But let's see how it does with the rinsing. See the suds inside. So, suds lock. Didn't suds lock on us though, which is good. I'm gonna give it a little bit more water. I'm gonna reset it and give it a little bit more water for a little bit better rinse, theoretically. Should start here soon. Now this is warm. What I would consider that warm, yeah. I think it opens the cold a little more than it does the hot. There it goes. Well, there's our towel. Oh, pretty clean now. Not doing so bad. See many suds. We'll see. Other video, this thing had a tendency to move back and forth just slightly. Now it's not doing it. So, but it's not filtering. So, when you got your normal speed on, I'm gonna reset that back below. I think there's a way to adjust them. I'll have to figure that out. If anybody knows, let me know. Alright, just about empty. Can you hear it? Yep, siphoning. 90 seconds. Just gonna switch. Goes. It's moving a little bit. I gotta get this front leg up or down to balance it out because it's kind of going a funky way. That looks weird. Now it's doing even more set skills. I think when I tried to jam it, lifting it up, and didn't like that when it was moving. So this front right foot right here is a little low. I'm trying to tinker with it. Obviously can't do it when it's running, obviously. Don't ever do it while it's running. You see it moving slowly. It's jiggling. It doesn't jiggle as bad as some of the other machines. I just need to get them on a nice solid concrete floor. They won't ever move on me ever again. machine. A couple years in the making. I didn't expect it. I wasn't expecting... Oh, I didn't mean to do that. I accidentally bumped the timer. Oops. Honestly, I didn't expect this machine to run whatsoever. It runs pretty good. It's not perfect. Of course, when you're 40-something years old, you're not going to run perfect. Oh, Whirlpool clock over there.
Yep, it's done.
I didn't give it as much time as it should have gotten it. Not too bad. Yep, that's what it was. And himself forgot. Whatever, where did it go? A quarter, so. Here's pants. I didn't give it as much time, I accidentally bumped the timer. The phone dropped twice this cycle, so I gotta figure something out for that. Where is the quarter? That will... whatever. Here. They smell clean. Oh, there's a key right here, too. That's key. What a dummy. Alright. I forgot my key in there. So let's see how this came out. Not bad. Got a little crap right there. Pretty good. So, yeah, it came out pretty clean. Not perfect, but pretty clean. So far this machine's doing pretty good. That's what that scratching was, is the darn key and quarter. So other than that, it ran pretty good. Hopefully you guys liked the video. Sorry about the camera and keys. And I'm still learning, and I'm still learning about this machine. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, and, please let me know in the comments section what you think of it, and if I can do any suggested videos. Thank you for watching.